Good morning. A very warm welcome to all of you and welcome back to Commerce Study Center. As you know, we are discussing about chapter 4 elements of marketing mix in subject marketing for class 11. We have seen 4 P's of producer oriented model. Now today we will be seeing 4 C's, consumer oriented model of marketing mix. Now why this is required? Because in modern times, the transition has taken place from 4 P's to 4 C's. Now, why this has happened? Because producers or sellers, you can say, or marketers, you can say, they have become more focused towards consumer. They feel that consumer is the king of the market. There is no doubt about it. And everything, the 4 P's are related to the consumer only. So, it will be better to understand 4 P's from consumer's point of view. But if you want to understand that, then the 4 P's have to be transferred, or they can be thought from consumers, that is 4 C's point of view. Now let us see. Now we know consumer has gained a lot of importance, and that is why 4 P's have been shifted to 4 C's. What shift has taken place? Product has been shifted, product has been replaced by customer value. Now this is very clear. Why? Because product, any product, if you think from consumer point of view, he is associating certain kind of value to it, because he is putting his time, he is putting his energy, he is putting his efforts, he is putting his money to buy the product. So ultimately some value association is taking place. That is why product has been replaced to customer value. Price has been shifted to, has been replaced by cost, because ultimately it is the cost that consumer is paying. Place has become transferred, has been replaced to convenience. Now people are more focused, where is it convenient for me to go and buy? Is it feasible for me to travel so long and to buy certain product, or is it easily available? So now place has gained recognition in terms of convenience, and promotion has replaced by communication. Promotion, yes, from producer's point of view you can say promotion, but what is the aim of promotion for producers? To communicate to the customers about the product, about the features of the product, about the benefits of the product. Whatever product related information has to reach to the customer. So ultimately it becomes communication for the consumers. This way 4 P's have been transferred to 4 C's. Now one more important concept here is marketing mix for service sector. We have understood from producer's point of view, we have understood from consumer point of view. Now we need to understand it from service point of view. And when we say service, now there are total 7 P's which have been introduced under services as element of marketing mix. Why? Because an expanded marketing mix was proposed by Booms and Bittner. It was proposed by Booms and Bittner, and traditionally it had only 4 P's, but later they realized and they added 3 more elements to it, that the additional elements go beyond conventional 4 P's and distinguish customer service for service firms from that of manufacturing firms. Earlier producer means manufacturer, now service sector also has been included, and they also need to understand the elements of marketing mix. What are these 7 P's service marketing mix? So here is the understanding of 7 P's. In between there is a target market, that is the audience, and then place, price, promotion, we know, product, place, price, promotion, these are the 4 P's. Additional are people, physical environment and process. These 3 have been added, so it becomes 7 P's. Product, we know, any product which gives satisfaction to consumer wants or needs, that is tangible goods, intangible goods, comprise of product. So when we say service of marketing mix, service under marketing mix. So to develop a good customer service, the service marketer should focus on tangible cues and also create a strong organizational goals under product. This can be done by communicating clearly to the customers for features of the services being provided. If it is tangible product, they have to have effective communication through services or through features by describing the features in such a manner that customer gets convinced with the product. If it is intangible product, then they have to focus accordingly. Here, this is an example. ICICI Bank, when we say product and services, they have traveler's check, they have card, different kinds of cards, credit card, debit card, travel card, corporate card, loan, home loan, personal loan, business loan. Then investment is a service, insurance is a service, NRI banking is a service, deposit is a service. So they have to, how they will communicate. So this is the example how they communicate. Now this is an advertisement given by ICICI Bank. Offers, they are also giving offers. And they are displaying it in such a manner that all the information is also given related to product and services, and it is communicated effectively. If I am planning to open a bank account, if I see the ad once, at least I will think of visiting them or talking to them. So how you display, how you communicate in under service sector, that also plays an important role. Here they are into consumer banking, cards, investment banking, loans, etc. As per the needs and wants of the customers, they are trying to attract them through the advertisement. Second, price. Now due to intangible nature of the service, price becomes an important quality indicator. Why? Because it is essential that service firms provide competitive pricing, thereby getting an edge over competitors. When we are deciding about the price, we have already seen price as an element of marketing mix. Scheming price, penetrating price, etc. You have to concentrate on competitors' price also before you decide the price. So you have to bring a cutting edge to your product compared to competitors' product. You want that people should focus more buying your product more than the competitors. So your pricing scheme should be according to that. Big Bazaar is an example given over here as a price fixing. Why? Because they focus, their objective is to get maximum market share. Now, as we know, pricing objectives differ from company to company. If sales maximization is there or maximum market share is the objective, then pricing strategy will change. So, but Big Bazaar, as an example, they focus more on maximum market share. So, their pricing techniques will be different. How they have taken? Value pricing, everyday low pricing. Now, Big Bazaar promises consumers the lowest available prices without coupon clipping, waiting for discount promotions or comparison shopping. Big Bazaar generally gives the products at a lower cost compared to other supermarkets, if you can compare. So this is one pricing strategy they have come up with. Then they go for promotional pricing. We have seen promotional pricing like products available at rupees 99, product available at rupees 49 to attract consumers. Then special event pricing discount or discounting schemes, buy two get one, that all is promotional pricing. They have also gone for differentiated pricing in terms of peak and non-peak hours. If they know, ladies, housewives, if they are coming in the evening, that become peak hours for them, and that time the price of the products will be varying from the non-peak hours. So differentiated pricing also they have attempted as one of the pricing strategies. Then bundling, combo packs, buy two get one free, that's what I told. Good Day family pack is available at rupees 60. Then 5 kg oil, 5 kg rice, 5 kg sugar for rupees 599, all mixed combo pack at rupees 599, which is basically to attract the customers. Then place. Services are performance which cannot be stored. Hence, business offering services find it difficult to balance between supply and demand. Now, a service firm must make simultaneous adjustments in demand. Now, if your supply goes high and you are not able to create that much of demand, the stock, it will remain in the stock. Like for example, service we are talking about. So let's come back to the original example of ICICI Bank. If they promote too much of insurance, but they have hired people also, they have taken the place also, they have given employment to a lot of people, and they are trying to target the market, they are trying to target the people who want to do investment in insurance, but still they are not able to get that much of. So supply and demand is not matching here. So that time we have to identify, ICICI Bank has to identify what are the differences, why it is not picking up. Is the place a problem? Is the bank location where we are placed is not convenient for them to come and approach us, or maybe our approach itself is wrong. A service firm must make simultaneous adjustments in demand and capacity to achieve a closer match between the two. So they have to match between supply and demand. The firm could choose to use multi-site locations to make the service more reachable. Like for example, Domino's Pizza. If you see Domino's Pizza, home delivery is there. Location-wise home delivery is there. Maybe they will charge little extra to provide, but they will deliver it. So this products which are available easily, conveniently from place to place, customers will be more attracted towards it. Same if I want pizza from Pizza Hut, but if he will not deliver here, I will not go for it because it is not convenient for me. I will immediately call the Domino's Pizza and order because I know they will deliver here. Then comes promotion. Now service marketer, the service industry, they constantly have to put themselves into too much of advertising, too much of word of mouth communication has to take place. That is one technique through which they can gain more customers, because it's a service, it's an experience, and more people share about it, it will be spreaded more to the other customers. Communication involves informing the customers in a language they best understand. Maybe especially in case of services, post-purchase communication is very important, because retaining existing customers is very important. These existing customers only will bring the new customers, because these existing customers will share their experiences. Many of the online sites, if you have seen, they give testimonials. Now, testimonials is one technique that company adopts to reach out to the new customers, telling that our existing customers are very happy with the performance of the company, with the service of the company, and so they have given their testimonials, they have verified that company is very good, and it becomes an attraction for the new customers to come in. How do you promote services? That plays an important role. For example, Vodafone, one of the world's greatest telecommunication brands, frequently uses local recognition to reach and maintain the trust of the local customers. Telecommunication, if you know, this Vodafone is a giant telecommunication company, and it often uses popular stars like Maricom, David Beckham, Michael and others, and they advertise its brand value and offers through billboards, TV commercials. So they are taking support of all these promotional tools which may be required to promote the product, to advertise the product and to reach out to the customers. Physical evidence. Now what is physical evidence? It is like environmental surroundings greatly affect the customer's expectation of the service. As services cannot be readily displayed, a conducive environment is provided to the customers to feel the place, to feel that they are at a they are in the conducive environment. Physical evidence is required, like when we take to cafe coffee day, CCD. It's a very special place, it's a very the ambience is so beautiful, the infrastructure has been developed, that you come, cozily sit, have coffee, do your business meetings here. Why? That is a physical evidence. It gives a feeling, a conducive environment. That is also one source of promotion. People would not like to wait if the surroundings of the place are made to wait or are unpleasant. If cafe coffee day was not being designed in such a manner and there was a huge line behind there standing outside for the turn to come, then it may not have happened. Now it happens generally it happens with very good name restaurants like in Pizza Hut also. If you have to stand outside for a long period of time, you may not prefer to do that, though you know pizza service is very good, pizza food is very good, everything is good, but still waiting is not possible with customers. So customers can be turned off by small changes in the design of the service facility also. So what is important over here? Physical evidence. What surrounding you are providing to the customer? How you are attracting them? Are you giving them a cozy place to come and sit? Are you making them comfortable? Are they feeling at home? That home feeling is there? Are they able to have that positive environment? That all is physical evidence. Then comes people. Now, if you see, most of the services are labor intensive because people are involved in it. Without people, service may not take place. So the behavior of the staff providing the service, how polite they are, how communicative they are, how they are able to convince or no, that all will play an important role when we say people, because they are ultimately selling the service. And when they are selling the service, it should show in their body language, in their verbal language, in their non-verbal gestures, how they are. For example, if it is a restaurant, the people who are serving inside, the reception, front desk, and then the manager, and then the waiters, how they are treating you, that all will play an important role. If you feel they are not behaving properly, food is getting delayed, it is not coming on time, whatever you ordered, you didn't like it, maybe cook is not proper there, that all will play an important role in promoting or talking negative about the service that you are selling. Because what happens, dissatisfied customers will definitely affect the quality of the service, and more word of mouth negative will be spread out to the customers. Okay, here is an example of Madhya Pradesh as a place to visit, and it is considered as one of the tourist place. Now here, tour operators or tourist transport operators, hotel staff, tourist guide, if they are not appropriate, if they are not able to guide you properly, then you will not be able to visit more oftenly, or you will not be able to convince others that they should go and visit a certain place because they had a good experience. Service is nothing but customers are sharing their experiences. That is very important to keep in mind. So the more confident they are about with the communication with the people involved in that, more rich experience they will be getting. And the last is process. Now, which process we are talking about here? The past experiences with the service also affects the expectations of the customer. Process, how the process took place, right from the pre-purchase or pre-service to post-service. Let's talk it from the place point of view only, Madhya Pradesh or any other place I want to visit. If it is a historical place, how the place has been maintained, how the tourist guide was, is rather before booking and after booking also, and after visiting the place, how was the experience. So pre-service booking, in between going through the experience, and post-service, I finished visiting, now I am sharing my experience. That is a process that I have undergone, and I will be sharing my experience as a customer to other customers. So how the process did it go smooth, or difficulties were faced quality wise, service wise, communication wise, that all plays an important role when we say process. So when I started my process, I had certain expectation as a customer, and when I ended up, I had an actual experience. So now from expectation to actual experience, it's a process. How genuine it was, how smooth it was, that will decide whether the service was of good quality or no. So these are my 7 C's of service marketing mix. Here they have given example of Apollo Hospitals. The process at Apollo Hospitals, one of the premium hospitals, is involves established procedures and documentation. It plays a major role in medical concept. This is primarily because the group has continuously been at the helm of several game-changing innovations in India. So, how smooth the transaction takes place with the patients, that also will decide about the service and how good or how bad it was. So these are 7 C's of consumer oriented model. In the next video, we will be seeing further. Stay connected. Do not forget to